Working as a postman in Gloucestershire, George Young developed an intimate knowledge of the Cotswolds around Stroud and Chalford. A self-taught musician and artist, photography and architecture are just two of his lifetime interests. Today, in the crisp warm light of summer, he is completing a photographic survey for his next painting. George's home at France Lynch, high above Chalford's Golden Valley, is typical of the cottages in many of his paintings. The pots and pans have been pushed aside, and the kitchen is transformed into a studio.
Yes, I started this painting in 1976. And of course, I said, I can't do that unless I'm absolutely in the mood. Of course, I've been painting ever since I was going to school. You see? And of course, but as I say, it's got to be just the kind of picture I want. You know what I'm saying? For my own self, I like scenery. Really? Well, of course, being interested in the church of my own, of France Lynch, I naturally thought I'd ever go up the Cirencester Parish Church. I have painted on hardboard. On both sides I've tried. I tried the rough side, I tried the smooth side. But on this occasion, I chose the canvas board, and I begin to think that's the best. So I'm very interested. I'm not satisfied unless I can get the third dimension to a certain degree. Of course, I like to get it as new as I can to life. You see? That's why it is. That's what brings me into the detail work, you see? Rather than the heavy, you know. I'm not satisfied with just giving a blob or two. That don't appeal to me. Of late years, I find it better, much easier, really, for me, is to take my camera and take it for the colour camera, bring it back in home, and then work up from it, instead of going outside and coming down. Of course, when I start off, I do the sketching pencil work, you see. It's going to take me perhaps a couple of hours, I expect. Then I should have to leave it alone. I soon get tired up with that. I said, it's not easy, you know. Then and then of course I might leave it several days before I attempt to go back for there. Because I got to feel just like it, you know. Of course I've done flower designs as well on tablecloths, you know. But not with this particular kind of paint. I was a postman from 1924 at the Chalford office, see? And of course I used to go round to Oakridge, Hyde, Phantom Mansell, not Eastcombe, Brownsville. That was at Chalford. Well then when I was moved to Stroud, I was on Bisley Road, top of the town. And I had to do one or two other places in the very good first going off to get used to the places. But I was fixed on this Road. The Cotswold area I like very much. And of course, I said I've been, especially been on the post rounds, you see. And of course, naturally, I've painted several scenes. And different people's got them in their own houses, you know, of my paintings, you know. And how often people say to me, have you put yours in the subscription rooms? I said, no, I never have. Mine's in the village. When I mix my colours, there's no trouble to me. I said, it comes to me. There's no, I ain't got to fiddle about or anything like that. I said, I know near enough for the instinct what I want. I said, one of my colours is sap green, burnt sienna, and black, and yet you hear it that you're not supposed to use black, but I use black. I said, I have my own way about that. I use black if I want it. An umber, burnt umber, yellow ochre, sometimes emerald green, olive green, and viridian green, and titanium white. That's most of my colours. Sometimes I mix my colours on the palette, and sometimes I mix them on the actual painting, on the canvas.
If George had to select one favourite from his paintings, it would probably be France Lynch Church.
I was in the choir in France Lynch Church ever since 1924. And of course, I took this again off a postcard, but it wasn't a coloured postcard, it was black and white. Therefore, being in the church and the choir so long, I took notice of all the colouring in the church, and therefore I applied it to my painting.
The Red Lion, Chalford, and when Temple Thurston cruised through the Golden Valley in the Flower of Gloucester, the scene would have differed little from this. There is a mist of gold into which all tones and shadows melt, like metal cast into a furnace, mills and factories, blue slate roofs, and grey houses. Wherever there is a field in which pasture is left to grow, there the grass is of a golden green, accentuated, there is no doubt, by the sheets of cowslips which are spread everywhere in every open space.
I was born in the south, east, south London. See? Not far from the city. I was born at Camberwell, near Kennington, the Oval. I said, being living in London, and like I was born there, as I say. Of course, I used to like to see the St. Paul's Cathedral, you know, and the Tower Bridge, etc. Of course. Then, of course, when I saw a postcard of it, I thought, naturally enough, I wanted to paint it. Well, I don't know why it, I don't know why it is or why it should be. It's not because I don't think I'm coming to the end of my tether, but it makes me feel that I'm getting more tired now, you see. Well, in other words, what I'm trying to say is, if I do anything painting from now on onward, it won't have to be a big job. I could do a small one, might do a little tiny job. Huh?
Satisfied with the finest detail, George Young has completed another masterpiece in his own distinctive style. Thank you.